Hello and welcome to this tutorial on showing mouse press by changing the cursor texture, in other words, cursor sprite or image. I have written a simple mouse cursor image change with mouse release and press circuit, and I will be showing you that. Using this, you can quickly change the texture of the cursor. And for the next tutorial, I will be using the setup to show you mouse presses. Because in play mode, when the mouse does not change, mouse presses are not very convenient. For example, this setup is from my drag and shoot tutorials, and I couldn't demonstrate the mouse presses and releases in that series. Going back to this tutorial, here I have some cursor images and their texture types are set to cursor. We will be setting them as texture for mouse press and release. This approach could use other texture types like Sprite 2D, but it does not always be the best or expected output. So believe me and stick with using cursor for texture type. The script that we will walk through is called show cursor. It has three variables, set from the editor, two textures and one cursor mode. Release state's texture will be the texture that the cursor have when it is not pressed, and press state texture is the texture that the cursor will have when it is pressed down. Cursor mode mostly helps us with how scaled we want our texture to look and set the textures for specific operating systems and circumstances. For example, if you set auto, you get your cursor to be scaled as the default size of the OS that you use and that you see outside the game tab. And if you set it to for software, you will be seeing the scaled versions of the cursor textures. For my tutorials, I will be using the setup in auto mode. Lastly, you can put this behavior to any object in the scene. That's enough for the editor. Let's have a look at the script. Simply put, in the first frame, we set the sprite of the cursor to release its sprite. In the update, we check if the left mouse button press or release. In the frames, we change the cursor image. If press state, set press image. If release state, set release image. We change the cursor image using cursor class set cursor function, and this function requires texture 2D as the texture to show as cursor. This includes most of the texture types, but again, you should set the texture to cursor. We have two textures for the states of the cursor, release state and press state. At the start, mouse is not pressed, so we start with setting the texture to release state as initial state. Later on update, if input.getMouseButton0 returns true, that means the left mouse button was pressed, and we set press state as the texture for the cursor. Vice versa, input.getMouseButton0 returns true, that means the left mouse button is released, and we set release state as the texture of the cursor. Here we have two more variables, hotspot and cursor mode. These are also information needed for set cursor function. Hotspot is the position where the mouse cursor really is and starts from left top corner at 0,0. And this is where we want our mouse cursor to be detected, so we set this value to vector3.0. If you want another point other than the left top corner of the image to be a click hotspot, you need to set its value regarding that point and give the function's different value too. Lastly, cursor mode. This is where things get a little tricky. There are two values, auto and for software. Simply, if you set it to auto, you get your cursors scaled to size of original operating system cursor. If you use for software, you can see your cursor target size you want to set, so use it regarding your needs. With that, this will be how I will be setting and changing the cursor images in next tutorials. Technique mouse press demonstrations. Probably all the ones that is not VR, and you can change your cursor using this tutorial as well. As always, if there was a point not clear, let me know in the comments down below. If you like this video, give it a like and subscribe for the future ones. I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!